that what you're saying?
You're up.
All right.
All right. Hello, everybody. Rick with Spokane Valley Fire Department. I'm here with Captain Paul Kimball. We're talking about Wildfire Awareness Month. It's May 11th. We're 11 days into the glorious month of May. We got a beautiful sunny day, and we got lots of fire trucks down here at the intersection of Bowdish and Dishman Micah. Had to look for that one back in my head. Anyway, Captain Kimball, what are we doing today?
Today, we're getting our firefighters back to the basics. Every year, we go over wildland training and get our crews ready for the next season. And this year, we're just talking about the basic of the basics.
Right,
getting a firm foundation.
When we got here, I heard some chainsaws running, so that's one of the basic things. So talk to me real quick about what we're teaching them as far as chainsaw work goes.
So for chainsaw work, we have a policy on what we can cut, when we can cut, and we're making sure we understand what that is so that we can operate within our policy safely using chainsaws, specifically on wildland fires.
Right, and some of the policies are eye protection, hearing protection, chaps, I mean safety stuff. Mm-hmm. We got to do it safely because if we cut our leg off, we can't help you. So we got to learn all the safety stuff. Just like you should, we have to. Same thing.
Yep.
And then I heard something about hand tools, which, by the way, is one of the hardest jobs in the world, is digging hand line. It sucks.
So hand tools, those are your shovels, Pulaskis, Combi tools, McLeods, different tools you use by hand to dig fire line. So we're teaching crews, how wide do you dig the fire line? How deep do you dig the fire line? And the fire line's job is to contain the fire so it doesn't spread.
So it basically makes a layer of dirt so the fire can't continue to move through a field or up a hill or down a hill, that sort of thing. And then you were talking about something else. Oh, total extinguishment, putting out hot spots.
Yep.
So what's some of the secrets to that work when we see a hot spot in the middle of a black field?
So after we've contained the fire, our next job is to make sure that it's completely out. We don't want to come back the next day for a smoke. We don't want the fire to pick back up after we left and continue to grow. So some of the techniques we use are, one term that we use is called cold trailing, which means I take my hand, the back of my hand, and I'm feeling the ground, and I'm feeling for any heat, because sometimes there's heat and we don't have any sign of it. No flames, no smoke, but there's heat.
Sure.
If we find that heat, we dig it up, put water on it, find that organic material that's burning, and make sure it's out.
Right. So lots of stuff going on here, out here at Dishman Micah and Bowdish. And we're gonna be here for the next 2 days, and we're also gonna be here next week, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. Now we're gonna bump it up a notch on that particular. Actually, we're gonna do some live fire stuff.
Not live fire next week, but next week it's a scenario.
Yeah.
They take everything they've learned, put it all together, and they run with it. This is instructor led. Next week they're leading themselves.
Right. So they're going on a call. There's gonna be a scenario. They've got to deploy the right equipment. They've got to have the right communications. They got to ask for the right resources. It's where they're gonna just reinforce those things that we've learned in years past. Yep. We're getting ready for wildfire season, which comes every year. That's why we have Wildfire Awareness Month, is so that you can help us take care of your stuff, right? So make sure you are ready for what's coming, because it comes every year. I appreciate y'all. Paul, thanks very much for interviewing. We'll probably be back out here next week. We'll talk to you again.
Thank you, Rick. Thanks, Scott.